Lymphoid tissue is found throughout the mucosal lining of human body and they are called mucosa associated lymphoid tissue. And one such collection of lymphoid tissue at the entrance of the respiratory and digestive tract is called the Waldeyer's ring. So Waldeyer's ring is often asked as short note and also it can be asked to draw a label. So today I'll explain what is Waldeyer's ring. Actually there are two rings, an inner ring and an outer ring. So what are they, what constitute this and what are the functions of this Waldeyer's ring? I'll explain that. Okay, so this Waldeyer's ring is named after a German anatomist. Okay, Waldeyer's ring. So as I already told you, this mucosa associated lymphoid tissue is present throughout the mucosal lining of the body and the name is different in the according to the regional anatomy. If they are present associated with the gut mucosa, they are called a gut associated lymphoid tissue, and if they are present in association with the nasal mucosa, and they are called the nasal associated lymphoid tissue. So actually this Waldeyer's ring is can be included under nasal associated lymphoid tissue or NALT. Okay, so it's very simple actually. The thing, the inside, you know, there is a nasal cavity, then palate, between this comes the tongue musculature, okay, your tongue terminates, okay, so you know that inside in the posterior, the junction of roof and the posterior wall of nasopharynx comes the adenoid, okay. So above there is adenoid tissue, or it is called the nasopharyngeal tonsil, isn't it? And then on the lateral wall of nasopharynx at the tubal elevation, just behind the tubal elevation, you can see the tubal tonsils. It comes here laterally, the tubal tonsils or the Gerlach's tonsil, Gerlach. Okay, so here this is adenoid, then the tubal tonsils on both sides, and what comes in the oropharynx, oral cavity, oropharynx, here comes the tonsils or the palatine tonsils. Okay, we usually call it the tonsil, palatine tonsil. Then at the posterior one third of tongue, posterior to circumallate papillae, there is lingual tonsil. Okay, so when it comes here, your oral cavity, and tongue, here comes your palatine tonsil and the lingual tonsil behind the circumallate papilla. Okay, so imagine this as a ring. You can imagine this as a ring which is connected with the adenoid, then comes the tubal tonsils or the Gerlach's tonsil on both sides, then your palatine tonsil, and after that comes the lingual tonsil. So this becomes the Waldeyer's inner ring. Okay, Waldeyer's inner ring. So if there is an inner ring, there should be an outer ring also. Okay, so what comes the what constitute the outer ring? So this outer ring constituted by lymph nodes in the neck from which this inner ring structures drain. Retropharyngeal adenoids drain into retropharyngeal lymph nodes. Retropharyngeal Then this actually the tubal tonsils and adenoid drain into uteropharyngeal. Palatine tonsils usually drain into, they drain to jugulodigastric lymph nodes. There is jugulodigastric lymph node on both sides. Then next is jugular chain of nodes. There are upper jugular, mid jugular, and also there is lower jugular. Here also upper, middle, and lower jugular node. Then comes this submandibular and also submandibular. Okay, submandibular. This is jugular group, submandibular, both side, and also submandibular. Again, we can make it into a ring-like structure. So retropharyngeal, then jugulodigastric, upper jugular, mid, and in, lower jugular chain, submandibular and submandibular. Again, it forms a ring-like structure formed in the outer ring. So the Waldeyer's ring, inner ring is formed by adenoid, the adenoid or the nasopharyngeal tonsil, then the tubal tonsils on the lateral wall of nasopharynx, palatine tonsils or the tonsils on the lateral wall of oropharynx, and the lingual tonsils situated on the posterior third of tongue that constitute the inner ring, and the outer ring are formed by the lymph nodes present in the neck. They are the retropharyngeal, jugulodigastric, jugular chain, submandibular and submandibular. Okay. Now what are the functions of this? That is also important. Why this, what is the use of this Waldeyer's ring? As you know, the one thing is that this acts as like our security guards. So they protect the lower respiratory as well as digestive tract. Okay, so protection, that is one thing. Because no exogenous aggressors or intruders can pass without bypassing them. So that is one role is protection. The second is that they are constantly exposed to antigenic stimuli, isn't it? All these antigens or the exogenous intruders, aggressors will pass through this. So they are constantly exposed to antigenic stimuli. So they will process this malt, mucosa associated lymphoid tissue, will process antigen, okay, and will present it to T helper cell and B cells, okay, and B cells. So actually it is plays a role in boosting immunity. Next is production of immunoglobulins. Especially IgA, IgE and IgD. Production of this Waldeyer's ring is actually a part of mucosa associated lymphoid tissue which is present at the junction or around digestive and respiratory tract. It has got an inner ring formed by adenoid, tubal tonsil, palatine tonsil and the lingual tonsil, and an outer ring by the retropharyngeal, jugulodigastric, jugular chain, submandibular and submandibular lymph node which are present around the neck. And these are the functions, and also it is one of the common sites of extranodal lymphomas, especially malignant lymphomas, staging changes according to Ann Arbor staging, and also remember the physiological hypertrophy it undergoes during childhood, and if it is persisting towards puberty or adulthood, there is need of removing this adenoid, that is adenotonsillectomy. Okay, thank you.